Thank you, Mr. Speaker. I certainly do want to talk about the budget, and I will be splitting my time, Mr. Speaker, with the member for Brandon Buren St. George's. I want to discuss budget 2015 in detail with regards to science and technology and research and experimental development. And I'd like to start first by talking about why that's important. It's important because we must invest in the future. If we want our grandchildren to have well-paying jobs, they need the know-how, the tools, the equipment, the infrastructure, the community to be productive. And if you're productive, you can command good salaries. We need to stay on the forefront of technology to do that. If we want our grandchildren to have jobs where they have a competitive advantage, where they're working in an area where Canada and its Canada's competitors have a barrier to entry, then science and technology and innovation is a prime source of that advantage. And if we want good jobs to stay in Canada for our grandchildren, then we have to develop in here. We have to develop new industries, not only new companies, but we have to develop new industries, which means companies around emerging technologies, but also the supply chain, the partners, the pool of skilled labor, the finance, all of the infrastructure. And those are the things that will create good jobs for our grandchildren. In light of the finance minister's comment that the prime minister's granddaughter could fix any problems in the budget, I say let's give our grandchildren resources to fix problems, some wealth-generating resources to help them, and they will need it because our grandchildren, it seems, will be taxed by the burdens left behind by a short-sighted, closed-minded, innumerate, and ideological conservative government. I want to talk about the budget in detail now, and I'd like to start by looking at federal spending on science, technology, research, and development in constant $2007 dollars. This comes from data collected by Statistics Canada. It's government spending on science and technology corrected for inflation. In 2005-2006, the spending in all of the federal government was $10.0 billion. This was just before the Conservatives took power. In 2014-2015, the fiscal year just completed, the number, according to Statistics Canada, corrected for inflation was $9.1 billion. And so federal government spending has gone down by $900 million a year before we even get to anything announced in the budget. And remember, Mr. Speaker, that there were cuts to the scientific research and experimental development tax credit announced in 2012, which aren't counted, because Stats Canada is only counting contracts, grants and contributions, and research fellowships. So that tax credit, which was cut for scientific research and experimental development in the private sector, that really kicked in last year and this year. So in 2014-2015, $315 million cuts to tax credits. This year, $480 million. Next year, $500 million. This is money that's not going into companies that are doing research and development here in Canada. I want to now deconstruct what the government would say in reply to that. The government has been saying that $11 billion in new investments in science, technology, and innovation have been made since 2006. So I put that, in a written order paper question, which is Q950, asking for a breakdown of that $11 billion. And what the answer shows is that when money was moved from one place to another, it was called new spending. And aside from about $3 billion in stimulus spending right after the recession, there wasn't really any new spending. The government, when they talk about this $11 billion, does not account for any cuts, especially inside the federal government. Environment, Fisheries and Oceans, StatsCan, and the government does not account for inflation when it quotes this number. The most egregious example, I think, is that the government told me in the reply to the written order paper question that included in this $11 billion was $110 million a year of new money for IRAP, the Industrial Research Assistance Program, and $400 million one time for a venture capital fund investment. But if anybody remembers Budget 2012, that was supposed to be paid for by cuts to the Scientific Research and Experimental Development Tax Credit for the private sector. That $500 million a year cut in support for private sector R&D swamps that new spending. And at this point, I want to make some special mention for the cuts to the eligibility of capital expenditure for the Scientific Research and Experimental Development Tax Credits. We've heard that from a number of companies that it should not have been eliminated. Some companies are labor intensive, others are much more capital intensive, and there's no good reason for favoring one over the other. I will say, to the credit of the industry minister, who was not the minister in 2012, when he was in my riding in Kingston in the Islands, somebody asked him, actually somebody who owns a company, asked him about the exclusion of capital expenditure. Now, he sounded open to reversing that mistake, and I hope that he himself will look at that and change the government's policy in the budget implementation legislation. Now I'd like to talk about particular lines in the 2015 budget. Mr. Speaker, there was a line in there for Canary, which is Canada's internet backbone. The government said that it would spend $21 million a year for 5 years. Problem is, that's just continuing the current level of spending, which is $20 million a year, with a little inflation adjustment. So great, it's worth a congratulatory tweet from the minister, but the minister forgot to mention that the budget, it's now $20 million. It used to be $30 million before this government cut the budget in 2012. Budget 2015 also mentions funding for the CFI, $1.33 billion over 6 years. So I talked to somebody at CFI, Mr. Speaker, and they tell me, yes, you know what, that's actually equivalent to just continuing funding at the current level. So nothing new there. National Research Council, $60 million a year for the next 2 years. 2 years ago, in budget 2013, the government said that they needed to spend an extra $60 million on top of the $900 million NRC budget to refocus NRC. And it's not clear to me whether they finished refocusing, whether these next 2 years of funding are required to continue the refocusing because it's taking a lot longer than expected, or whether NRC has found a good use for a permanent $60 million increase to its budget. You can't tell that from what the budget document says. MyTax internships, which connect graduate students in Canada by giving them industry experience. $14 million a year for 4 years, okay. Last year, when the last boost to MyTax was announced, budget 2014 moved the NSERC Industrial Postdoctoral Fellowships to MyTax and said that NSERC, Natural Sciences and Engineering Research Council, could use the money left over for other purpose, could reallocate it. This year, the government moves a different program, the NSERC Industrial Postgraduate Scholarships program, moves that over to MyTax to create internships, but it doesn't say that any money will be freed for NSERC. So we may actually be losing money over at NSERC to pay for this increase to MyTax. The budget is very different this year than last year. It's not clear at all that, I mean, it seems to me that there's actually going to be a cut at NSERC. And since we're talking about the research councils, we could go over their budget. 2015 announces $46 million for the three research granting councils, starting not this year but next year. Notice the skip in year. Problem is that the three research councils have a $3 billion budget. So you lose $30 to $60 million every year just from inflation. The government doesn't mention that. So a one-time boost of $40 million doesn't even cover the inflation, since we have to wait another year until it starts. Bread and butter research grants across Canada will shrink. That leads us finally to the new programs. Now, there are new programs. There's money for Triumph out in Vancouver, the 30-meter telescope, and the Canada First Research Excellence Fund. And I'm sure that good science will come out of these programs because of the proven quality of Canadian scientists. But the point I would make is that the funding on these new programs, it does not come near what all the cuts have been so far. And let me just summarize. The Conservative government's spending on science, technology, research and development, according to Statistics Canada, is down $900 million since they took power. Add to that another $500 million every year from cuts to the scientific research and experimental development tax credit for the private sector. Add to that another $102 million cut just because of inflation, and they haven't replaced the effects of inflation. That overwhelms the real new money in budget 2015. And so the conclusion is that the Conservative record on science and technology, and you'll hear the members, Mr. Speaker, on the Conservative side tout the extra spending, but if you really dig down into the numbers, you look back at the last 10 years, you look at inflation, you look at what's been cut elsewhere, in the federal government and in the private sector when it comes to research and development. And the talking points of the Conservatives fall apart. The Conservative government's record on science and technology and research and development is dismal, and they're failing our grandchildren. Thank you. Here, here.